Hi, everybody. I'm Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas. Good evening and welcome to the Metro Manila Arena. We're here in the Philippines for a much anticipated main event. 10 rounds of heavyweight action, and the anticipation for this bout has grown as the week has gone.
First of all, he's a good fundamental fighter, and he's not a real physical fighter. So he understands where he has to be good. He knows he doesn't have, you know, great personal skills where he can just knock a house over. He knows he has to be good in this area. He's an elite man.
Please lock that punch. But right on target with that double jab. He gets hit, but he gives it right back. Trying to score up top, but off the mark there. Good way to protect the midsection. 90 seconds to go here in this round. A little something for his opponent after getting tagged. Solid left hand to the head. Clean shot with the right. And now another left. Here's a moment here.
Joe, but he does is he forces him into a position to stop the punch. And then when he stops, steps back, makes a miss, and comes right back.
Back to the head he goes. Now hugging on the inside.
Double up the punches.
There's more room for defensive error with the taller fighter, I assume, here?
Yes, there is, because now all of a sudden you're punching down. You're taught to punch on a straight plane where you don't leave anything open. You punch down, and somebody comes up with a punch, next thing you know, you're picking yourself up off the canvas.
He's putting his punches together, the combination upstairs.
Keep your distance, man. When he misses one more punch,
listen to me. You're getting caught up. You're getting caught up in fighting and fighting. Focus for me.
Here we go. Round two is underway. Good job on the two-punch combo by Muhammad Ali. Including the ref or Doc stopping the fight.
Yeah, but you know, that's the funny thing for a fighter, for a professional Joe, I would argue with you. He's not supposed to worry about all those things. Now's really the time that he must not worry about any of those things.
Up top with the right hand.
Disagree. He is not being effective.
not at all. Why? Why is he not being effective? Because he's not thinking about what he's doing. He's just chucking punches. He's not really putting any interest behind him. Looking to where he has to go instead of just throwing.
Not hitting his mark there, going upstairs. Wow, is he defensively sound. And a punishing hook by Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Ali's banged by a big uppercut. And we come to the end of round number two. Well, we've seen this before, a fighter with a bad cut, and sometimes a fighter that now has a much greater sense of urgency.
Yeah, right now, if he was gambling and he was in a casino, he's rolling the dice. He's hoping to come up with seven.
Nice work on the outside. You need to move your head, okay? Side to side.
You got any more weight?
Boom! Counterpunch. Hold it.
More blocks?
Yeah.
Because when he misses, he's worried he's going to leave an opening.
Combo lands to the head. Good shot to the head with that right hand.
Come on, baby.
Off to the side, a little swing and a miss going upstairs. Now committing to that jab, straight hand, and it works out.
Been put there. You're gonna find out right now. He needs him right now.
Yeah, he throws punches, but he has no accuracy. Is this changing the fight?
Well, he has to if he wants to win this fight. And how does he change? Well, you know, the problem is these things have to be put in place in the gym. I don't know if you can do it right now, but if you could, you tell him in the corner, hey, tighten up a little bit, you know, shorten up these on punches.
For this round.
Because of what you just touched on, he's been a sharpshooter all night long.
One, two jabs up top.
Keep working the jab.
Nice. Nowhere close that punch by Muhammad Ali. Do you see any way in which he can take his opponent's aggression?
Yeah, the perfect way. I mean, boxing 101, counterpunching. You got a guy coming at you? No better way than to change his mind. Make him miss, make him pay.
Not one, but two. Good work with the jab up top.
Punch and move, punch and move.
Halfway through this round here. Fight has taken. I really like what he was able to do in that last round. Now he's behind on the scorecards, but you get the sense that the momentum is starting to roll his way.
Well, you get the sense that it's starting to become his kind of fight now.
Keeping him honest with a double jab up top. Ali's proving to be elusive. Piercing jab by Muhammad Ali. And you see he turned defense into offense, coming back with the counter punch.
And that's exactly into the game. He makes you miss, he makes you pay, and he makes you think twice about throwing a punch later on.
Committing to the head work, you see him go there again. Teddy, you know what I'm so impressed by. I'm not a case for fighting. It's ridiculous. But how hungry these guys are. How bad. Oh, he is stuck. He could go. Oh! And he crashes to the canvas once again. He's gotten up before. What about this time?
You're gonna find out exactly what he's made of.
He gives as well as he takes. You saw it on that exchange. Needs to improve that accuracy. Missed it. Oh, a big shot comes home for him. Can he beat the count? I don't think so here, Teddy.
Now I know where they got that saying, falling like a sack of potatoes.
How about a return to center with the left hand? Here in these later rounds, you can start to see a trend, and one is developing. He cannot get away from that left hand.
Now listen, when you throw your punches, it's not enough just to chuck them out there. You gotta throw them from the right distance. He's throwing them from a little bit too close, where he's throwing for his new set to that left hand.
Halfway through the scheduled rounds here. Yeah. Ali's right hand scores well. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. He comes with a straight right hand. On the receiving end of a big and X. Look at that. Ali's just going to go on. Once again, he hits the deck.
Well, he's getting practice at it, so he might figure it out. The next dawn, the dawn of the new beginning. More money. Knockouts bring money.
For Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore saying thanks for being with us. Hi, everybody. So glad you're with us. Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and we welcome you to the MGM Grand here on the Vegas Strip in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada, for tonight's main event. 10 rounds among heavyweights, and the anticipation for this bout has grown as the week has gone on. A lot of talk behind these two, and now it's time to walk the walk. just underway here, and you can already sense the type of fight we're gonna have. These are two guys that have flat out said it. They have come to get the other man.
And they're not lying.
Good combination punching by Isaac Cross there. The big man can put his punches together. A little give and take, and here comes the left hand. Tall guy versus short guy here tonight in front of us. Teddy, why does it seem so hard sometimes that some tall fighters don't necessarily fight tall?
Because, Joe, it takes great discipline to stay on the outside. You look at him, say, hey, you're tall. I wish I was tall like that. But now it takes restraint, control to stay in those corners and make sure you don't give in and allow the shorter guys to get close.
Super two-punch combo by Mike Tyson. Shot. Now he gives a left. Blocks away that headshot. Well played hook there. Tyson's just punching air that time. His opponent was able to get out of the way. And a big right hand comes crashing home from Tyson. Right to the belt line. The way these two are going at they're going to break the punch stat computer.
Well, they're trying to break more than that. They're trying to break each other's will.
10 seconds to go in this round. Isaac Cross really working well. That last round he was at. Look at the punch numbers. Here we go. Round two is underway. He scores with the jab. Good combination. Hook into the body with the left, and then going up top with the right. Hits him in the mug with the right. Tyson showing that he's got some defense of his own. He got away from that punch. A good headshot landed by Isaac Cross. Great work by the big man. Well, something's got to stick. He sends the combination to the body. You see what happens when he commits to the uppercut. Look at that. Great work there. Showing you that sublime skill right now with that two-punch combo. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left-hand scores. That was a miss by Mike Tyson. Teddy, the early life of Mike Tyson has been well documented, but you were the guy who first taught him how to really formally box. What do you remember those early days of getting Tyson into the ring?
I remember he was 12 years old, he was 190 pounds, and he was so fat. And I wanted to see a birth certificate to know if this was really true. He had physical tools we had not seen before.
And still accurate with that jab.
You're losing this fight. You can take some chances. You have to go.
And round number three is underway. Cross punch didn't come close. Targeting the left hand to the body. A stunning blow by Isaac across this heavyweight champ lets you know you're in a fight. Blocked that away. It was targeted for his head. Pulls the trigger right away with the left hand after getting tagged himself. Iron Mike with an iron right. Right back to the midsection.
Keep it going.
He tried to nab him up top, but was unable to connect. So the knockdown scored against Mike Tyson, but his opponent may want to watch out as Tyson has steadied himself back up on his feet. Comes right back with a shot of his own. On your scorecard, 3 rounds to 0. He's thrown a lot of punches, but he needs some better advice.
Yeah, well, one of the things that he could be told, and I would tell him, is move after your last punch. Don't stay at that weight for the receipt. He's paying a price.
And now we got a fight. He fires back a right hand of his own. Tyson's now switching things up. He was knocked down earlier, so now he's going to try to take a different course.
Now, that tells me, if I'm his opponent, a couple of Tequila, that he's very clever, that he's making a little switch, or just gives me confidence that he's desperate. You know, he's never done this before, and in my mind, I'm saying, I got him right where I want.
Isaac Cross is being smart on the outside. I think Isaac Cross should send the referee a thank you note for not seeing that foul. The referee gives him a warning for headbutting. Was absolutely a stunner.
And that came so wide that he had no preparation for it. That's where an awkward shot pays dividends.
Fight is over. A knockout. Unable to beat the count of 10. For the official word, let's send it up to the ring. Isaac Cross, your winner by knockout. And I think he was headed towards a decision win anyways, but what a good way to just put a stamp on his evening. Time at the fights. In the streets are gray. Good evening, everybody. Glad you've made the decision to be with us. Alongside Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. But the guy he's going up against tonight, he can take care of you.
Yeah, he can bang. The price is mine. He's got the good look, though. He figures everyone else, they have a little stiletto.
Wow, he backs up the combination, laying it all for him. Frazier's got a bad punch now. He's backed up by Teddy. He's got his guard up really well that time.
And he paid a price. Tying up a little bit, doing anything to kill the clock and not get caught on that punch anymore.
Goes upstairs with a right hand, left hook combination. What a high brain power punch by Kobe Nichols. Teddy, I don't think he's got visions of sticking around too long. He's in.
Yeah, he wants to make it a quick night.
Final 10 seconds of round number two. shoot by Joe Frazier.
Somehow it's part of your fucking strategy, right? Just sitting there, not playing the game at all. Fucking boring.
Joe Frazier in action here. First, most notable action of his career came on March 8th. Your winner by 9.